Hello and welcome to Let's Go Parking. This is our monthly show put on by the Berks County Parks and Recreation Department to tell you about what's going on in your county park system. My name is Becky Richards. I'm the Recreation Program Supervisor with the county, and this is my busy time of year. But fortunately for me, I got to be joined today with our Park Director, Cathy Wegener. Many of you know Cathy.
Hello, everyone. Nice to be back. I've been missing a show or two here for
I
a while.
Too. Yeah. We've been missing having you on, too. So Cathy's going to join me and talk about all the great things that are happening in the park in the month of December. Mm-hmm. But before we get started, Cathy was telling me about some exciting news that happened for the park system.
So yeah.
Tell us all about it.
Sure. Well, we're very excited to announce to everyone that we received a Department of Conservation and Natural Resources Community Conservation Partnership Program grant, most abbreviated as the DCNR C2P2 grant, for $71,500 to rehabilitate the access of the Union Canal Trail at Gring's Mill. Those of you that use the park perhaps know that's a pretty steep bank when you go across the concrete bridge at Gring's Mill and go down the trail. And we have had a lot of erosion problems there. Plus, it's an issue with park equipment and ADA compliance as well. So hopefully, towards the end of the spring, early summer, maybe not till next fall, depending how all the paperwork all falls together, we'll be seeing some work going on there to rehabilitate that area and make it a better access point for everyone. So we're very excited, very happy to receive that grant. It's been something that needs to be done for a long time. So,
right.
Yay.
That'll be great. Yeah. Great. Yeah. I've seen some, you know, the looking at the area, and, mm-hmm. and it'll be exciting to see how that turns out.
Yep.
So
good.
Very nice.
Okay.
Good. So we're going to jump right in because we have a lot to talk about. Mm-hmm. December is a very busy time of year for us. November goes very, very quickly as we're doing all of our prep work and getting ready for December. But starting off with everyone's favorite program coming out to beautiful Gring's Mill Park for holiday lights at Gring's Mill. This is, our 32nd year of holiday lights. it's so much fun. We love decorating the park, getting it ready, getting the barn ready, and having you come out to enjoy the holiday season with us. So our opening night is Thursday, December 5th. You can join us that night. Santa will be arriving at 6 o'clock. You can do the walkthrough light display. And then, depending on how it feels outside, warm up in the barn by the fireplace and listen to some great music. We're kicking off our opening night with Eric Hawala and friends. And he's bringing some of his good friends, Cliff Starkey and Jennifer Kinder, are joining him that night. So I think it's going to be a very busy night for opening night.
Great.
Should be a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, we have Santa Claus will be downstairs with some treats. We've got some treats from Tom Sturgis, R.M. Palmer Company, and Godiva Chocolate that you can enjoy. You can also take a walk across the cement bridge to the former generating station, and then you can visit our model train display inside mm-hmm. there. Yeah. We've been doing a lot of improvements to that over the summer and fall mm-hmm. here, so you might see some new changes yep. to that building.
It looks nice. Great. I stopped in yesterday and took a look at it. Looks nice. Looks like a little spruced up. I think people will enjoy it. If you've seen it before, there's still some of the favorite features like the drive-in movie theater.
Absolutely.
But there's some other things going on there. So look nice.
Right.
So, and I know the kids really enjoy seeing that, and adults as well.
They do. So, I say it's kids of all ages.
Kids of all ages, absolutely.
Enjoy going out to there.
Yeah.
So we'll be open every night, Thursday through Sundays, through December 29th from 6 to 9 p.m. It is just a $5 per car parking donation accepted at the gate when you come in. Our park rangers will direct you in where to park, and then you can enjoy the walkthrough light display. We've got a lot of great entertainment throughout the month. You can pick out one of our holiday lights brochures. We'll be out there. You'll start seeing them out in the general public very soon. We'll actually be at the parade this Saturday handing them out. They'll be out at your local libraries and in other various places you can pick it up. So you can see all the great entertainment that we have scheduled throughout the month. The reindeer will be coming back again this mm-hmm. year. They'll be coming back on Saturdays, December 7th and the 14th. They're there all night from 6 to 9 p.m. And then we also have the ice sculpting demonstrations. They're always so much fun. And I love seeing the circle of people around the ice sculpting, mm-hmm. you know, and asking questions and just watching those blocks of ice transform into some unique design. So this year, I know we're going to be doing a reindeer, and I'm not sure what the other design will be yet, but that'll be very, very cool. So I've got some pictures to show as we're talking about the program that we can scroll through, get you in the mood to come on out to Gring's Mill and see how beautiful the park looks. Mm-hmm. Our guys have been out there. We've been very fortunate with some really good weather that they've been getting out there and getting the park decorations up and ready. And who's ready for snow? Maybe not yet.
Yeah.
It does look so pretty.
But it does really make the park look nice when we have snow. And just enough to cover the ground, but still be able to come and park and walk down the hill.
That's all we need. You know, because it does make for great pictures. And it just looks so beautiful. And we often get a lot of people come during the daytime to take their family pictures, you know, for holiday cards mm-hmm. and newsletters. It's just such a great background.
So I know the guys are working hard. They've been doing a really great job. They've been moving along, getting things done. It's always exciting. Every day you come into the park and there's something else.
Something
completed.
New. See what's up.
So it's good.
It's good. And then we also have two Sunday afternoons where kids can come on out and make free decorations for their tree or their home. That's the first two Sundays, so Sunday, December 8th, and also the 15th between 1 and 4 p.m. Santa Claus will also be there in the afternoon, and the model train display will be open. We've got some very nice crafts to go in with our theme this year, which is a wintry woodland Christmas. I've kind of been working on this one for a little while. We've got some great ideas that we're going to enhance the barn. And it kind of seems like this is a really popular theme. I've been seeing it popping up in the mm-hmm. stores, too. Mm-hmm. So if you come out and you see a lot of plaid and...
red and grapevine.
Gnomes,
maybe. Yes.
This is all part of our theme and our decoration for inside the barn mm-hmm. this year. It'll be... It's always a fun time. To enjoy the day. Yep. And it's really only $5 per car to come on out and enjoy getting into mm-hmm. the holiday spirit. So we are closed and dark on Monday, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays, and Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. But there are so many other great days that we're open, some entertainment that the whole family will enjoy. We do have some nights that are more for families with young kids. We have our magician back. Daniel Clemente is always fun, and actually I know a lot of adults who really enjoy him too. He's just amazing to watch, and you really, he's one of those where you kind of really have to keep your eye on him because he's just, it's astounding what he can do. It's amazing. Yeah. And a lot of good favorites. We have some harp music back, our brass music, we have old-time Christmas songs and instruments with Keith Britzenhoff. He's on the December 12th with a couple shows. And then we always feature some nice music after Christmas to kind of start with that transition. Stephanie Grace is coming in with an acoustic trio in that weekend. And the Little Lehigh Band, a band that we've been hoping to work with over the summertime. It didn't work out, but we're kind of excited to bring them to our stage. It's a young family from Berks County. All very talented kids, and they also do a little step dancing with their music too. So very exciting to be able to fit them into our schedule this year, and you may see them around again next year.
And on those children's workshops, I think you have some other activities going on those afternoons as well, don't you, in the barn?
I forgot to mention about on the 8th, we are showing a movie. So while you're making those crafts and the decorations for your trees, you can sit and enjoy the Polar Express. Mm-hmm. We'll be on the 8th. And then on the 15th, we're bringing in our good friend, Grammy nominee, Ray Owen, and he's going to do some variety mixture of some of his different shows that he has. and a little music and comedy throughout the afternoon. Mm-hmm. So good. And then I'm also working on, we may have the Thunderbolts maybe joining us on the 15th in the afternoon. So we're still working with them on that. They may be popping in during the daytime to kind of show us some of the things that they can do. They put on a special Christmas show and they really wanted to come out and see it. So we're trying to see if we can fit them in where, you know, they'll be able to, you know, be able to have some people around to watch what they're doing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Good.
So please come out and join us anytime during the month. On we're opening December 5th through the 29th, Thursdays through Sundays, 6 to 9 p.m., closed and dark Monday, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays. So very exciting.
Yeah. I think you wanted to thank some people. Yeah. Oh. Yes, I was your next page. Well, your other page.
Oh, probably jumping around.
I know.
Well, and this program could not happen without the our amazing sponsors who come in. So the Township of Spring, you might see their bucket truck around in the park. Our guys have been using that when the township does not need that to help with putting up our tree decorations. We're actually doing some new landscaping around a monument that we have next to the barn. Anna Waltz Landscaping and Contracting is helping with the landscaping around there, which we're going to be able to put some decorations on. And then they usually help us. You might see, remember the blue tree that we had out in the field last year? That'll be back this year that we're borrowing from their business. And also some of the trees that we have inside the barn and outside the barn. And then we have a lot of advertising sponsors. So the Running Eagle Company, WEU, and Channel 69 really do help to promote the program out to Berks County and beyond so that, you know, people can find us and come on out and enjoy the great program. We also have back the holiday specs, the 3D glasses. We've got a couple new designs this year. Some Christmas trees, and I think it's a bald ornament. And then we have a really cool ornament done by Kim, our wonderful graphic designer. Kim did our limited edition 2019 Christmas ornament that'll be on sale for $7.50. So a couple things that you can buy down there. And hopefully you don't have any kids that are bad at your house, but if you do, we will actually have coal for sale down in our snack bar.
We have coal ready to go.
But I'm sure you don't have any kids who have been bad in your family, so you may not need that. But you can visit Santa and get a treat, so that's all good. And that's just one of the programs that we have going on in December. Then going on later in there's, since we're talking about kids being crafty and doing some gift items, Cathy, you want to talk about a program that Jennifer is doing at the Heritage Center.
Yep. So on,
and we have a poster about that,
too. We do have a poster on that? Okay. But on Saturday, December the 14th, Jennifer Brooks and Lisa Gauker, our environmental education staff, will be hosting a Nature Crafts for Kids workshop at the Heritage Center beginning at 1 o'clock. This workshop is for children ages 6 and up. And it's a drop-off program. So you bring your children there, drop them off, leave them with Lisa and Jennifer and the volunteers that are there so they can create special nature-related gifts for you. So this year's particular crafts are still a secret so that if the kids come, that you won't know what they are. But as an example, last year they made homemade lavender goat's milk soap and candles with dried flowers and a cup and some ornaments that they use some natural materials inside. So those are the kind of things that they would be making this time around. The cost is $5 per child, and you need to register for this program by calling Jennifer at 484-509-2667 or email directly to jbrooks@countyofberks.com. Of course, at the end of the show, you'll see our phone number. If you need to call us at any of our park offices, please do, and we can direct you and help get you and your children, or just your children, registered for the workshop on Saturday, December the 14th. So that's really a fun program, and it's nice to be able to use natural materials to make some different things.
Absolutely, and Jennifer and Lisa are always creative.
Yes,
so
they come up with some great things.
Program for only $5.
Exactly.
Great program.
Yep. All that same day, we have the Beidler House Colonial Candlelight Open House reception as well. And I think we have some photos of that, I think, as well.
We do.
So,
and a poster.
And a poster. One. And a poster. Really nice poster.
Up there it is.
So the Beidler House is in Gibraltar. It will be open that Saturday, December 14th from 1 to 6. So it's an afternoon where the house is decorated with traditional greens and traditional types of things that you would see in an 18th century home. There'll be music and dance and some snacks that you can have when you come in, some cookies and special kind of, we try to have old-fashioned kind of cookies and Stollen and German cakes and things so that you can sample that and speak with the volunteers and the people that are there as part of the holiday celebration at the Beidler House. There also will be a quilt exhibit on the second floor upstairs that you can walk through and take a look at. But it's really neat to see that home again in the winter time with the candles and the lights and just enjoy a kind of subdued holiday celebration. So again, that's on Saturday, December 14th from 1 to 6. You can stop in anytime, come through, spend a little time, and it's a come and go kind of program. So
Absolutely.
Drop your children off at the Nature Crafts Workshop, drive down to the Beidler House, and then go back and pick them up.
Oh, so, that sounds like
fun. I think that would be a good.
Have a great time.
Yeah,
and
I think that would work.
And you can kind of go and enjoy yourself at the Beidler House. And
yeah.
You didn't have to tell the kids about the goodies that you enjoyed while you were there.
That's right.
Absolutely. And there is a snow date for that, although hopefully we won't need
We will not need it. There is a snow date of Saturday, December the 21st, which hopefully we will not need it because as we go through this and we see the different programs here and the slides from previous Beidler events, we also have our winter solstice celebration with King Winter on December the 21st. So that program will come up at the Antietam Lake Park. It will be held at the Bingham Nature Center this year. It runs from 5:30 to 7:30 and will feature a hike, a lantern lit trail, like a brief outdoor night hike to be able to meet King Winter. He'll be there. He's returning once again. And then you can warm up next to the campfire. There'll be some stories that they'll share around the campfire, and there'll be a craft program inside the house at that evening. It is a free program, but we do ask you to pre-register again by calling the Nature Center at 484-509-2667 or email jbrooks@countyofberks.com. So there we go. In addition to the holiday lights, it's running the whole month from the 5th through the 30th, every right. Thursday through Sunday night. You've got the Nature Craft Workshop on the 14th. You've got the Beidler Candlelight Reception on the 14th. And then on the 21st, the Winter Solstice program with King Winter. So, yeah.
That's right.
So, a lot going on. And then, like I said, and things just continue. The parks are still open for you to get out and walk and hike, rain, snow, sun, whatever. So, come on out. The trails are open. There's still a lot of people getting outdoors. It's a good thing to get out. Even when it's cold, it's good for you. So,
I see people out there are still fishing.
Still fishing. Yep. Pretty amazing. Still people utilizing the skate park. The Action Park at Stone Cliff. So it doesn't matter if it's 34 or 74. It's still good to get outside. So
it's really nice to see the park in different times of year.
Mm-hmm. This is a perfect time if you're a bird watcher or enjoy nature, because with the leaves off of all the trees, you can really see the different birds and wildlife that's out there. Yesterday on the trail, I saw a deer just wading along the trail there. I passed a woman with a beautiful camera and a lens on it this long that was getting really up-close shots of some birds and things.
Nice.
So it's a great time. You can sometimes catch the bald eagle that comes around the park,
mm-hmm.
and the heron, which are, you know, like the large pterodactyl birds as they fly by. You can see them well, too. So
right.
it's a nice time of the year to get outside and still appreciate nature. Everybody needs a little time out.
Absolutely.
So.
Well, and we're already kind of planning on our programs for next year, so
mm-hmm.
we can kind of give you a preview. We'll have a first day hike again with puppy Zoe. We'll happen up at Antietam Lake Park. And when we come back for our December show, we'll be able to talk a little bit more about what we have planned. Mm-hmm. So we're starting to think ahead, even though we're very busy and working on our December programs. And we have volunteers out today out at the Heritage Center who are doing the bulk mailing of our Holiday Lights brochure. We have more craft preparation that we're doing for those craft prep days, the craft days on the 8th and 15th. So we have volunteers who are coming in and helping with activities like that, you know, cutting out things. So if you find that enjoyable, you can join our group of volunteers, you know, or even sometimes we have things that you can take home and do. And then the week after Thanksgiving, that Monday and Tuesday, we'll be getting into the barn at Gring's Mill and starting to decorate and set up the barn upstairs and downstairs with our decorations and decorating the trees for the program. And we're always looking for other hands because it just makes it go very quickly.
It makes it go easier. Yeah.
It does. And it's so fun to see how it all comes together. And it looks so nice, you know, ready for the program. Yeah. So we've got some special things that we're going to be decorating with this year. We always like to, you know, take some greens and put them around. And we have the lovely new windows. Remember the last year we got the new glass or the plexiglass in the tall slatted windows in the barn at Gring's Mill. Mm-hmm. So it brings a lot more light into the barn,
right.
And you'll be able to kind of look out and see even some more of the light display as you're sitting in there and enjoying the music. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it just adds a new dimension to the barn.
So
it's very, very cool.
It's good.
So we're really excited, you know, as we hear for the holiday season, before long it'll be Thanksgiving. One of the things that we kind of promote at the Thanksgiving time is there's this movement to opt to get outside for the day after Thanksgiving. So Black Friday, I know, you know, you might see some really great sales and deals that you might go out and do, but you may want to opt and get outside and enjoy nature that day too. So it's a great way, even the day of Thanksgiving, you've got family and friends are out, you know, or the day after or on any time on that weekend, you know, come out and enjoy the park and get some exercise. You can work off the turkey and the pumpkin pie.
So anyway, but maybe just to recap a little bit, so if people are just kind of catching this program towards the end, Becky's been sharing with you the Holiday Lights program that we hope that you'll come out and enjoy from December 5th through the 30th. Again, every Thursday to Sunday evening, the park will be open with the light display, and there's that musical entertainment, which is a real great variety of different things all those evenings that goes. And as she said, it's just a $5 parking donation when you come in. We appreciate that. It helps us with things within the park. And hopefully you'll enjoy the lights as you walk by, checking out the model railroad display, and talking with the volunteers that help to run that. They are, so most of them, very knowledgeable about model railroading. So if you're interested in that, it's a great time to talk to them. And of course, meeting Santa and making sure you've got your list ready for him. So all those things are great to come out and enjoy and see what's going on in December. So I hope that people will come out to the parade this Saturday. What did you say? It starts at 10 o'clock.
It does.
The park will be there with a float that's being put together as we speak. So it's a great time. You'll be able to grab a brochure from them there and just enjoy the holiday parade. I think it's a great way to kick off the season. Looks like the weather's going to kind of be okay. So you should be able to enjoy that on Saturday.
So you can, if you didn't get a chance to see us at the parade, we hope you will because it's going to be a fun day. Mm-hmm. But you'll also be able to pick up a brochure around different areas. So you'll be able to soon go out to your local library, come out to the parks. If you're on our mailing list, you should be getting that in the mail soon. Or just contact us at one of the park offices and you'll see our number come up here at the end of the program. Contact us, we'd be happy to send it to you. And that has that full list of the entertainment that we have scheduled through the month. So, and it does even mention the days that we have with the Nature Craft Display, the program, the Beidler House program, and the Winter Solstice celebration. So we promote everything. So here we are. Thank you for tuning in to Let's Going Parking with Cathy and I. Yep. And we hope you have a very nice Thanksgiving, and we'll see you next month for Let's Go Parking.
Bye-bye.